your warm-up. You're going to need a kettlebell and a band for today's workout, and we are going to get started with some hip bridges. So you're gonna lay it all the way down onto your backs. Your heels are wide, toes are turned up slightly, raised off the ground. Ready, we have 30 seconds before we head into this. I set my timer today so we have plenty of time for our warm up or to get into position. In a couple seconds, we're gonna get right into it. You've got about 40 seconds. So we've got booty and core today. We're gonna go through our warm up once, and then we're gonna get into part A, which is going to be our booty. Part B is our core, and then we're gonna end with our finisher. All right, guys, let's get right into this. Your elbows can dig into the ground. Sorry, I just lost where my thing was. Shoot, there it is. Okay, ready? So your lower back is staying on the ground to start. Your heels are digging into the ground, pushing your knees out, elbows grinding into the ground. You're gonna lift as one solid piece, squeezing the core and lower. Lift and lower down and lift, lower. Squeeze, driving those hip bones straight up towards the ceiling. Just warming up, getting our bodies a little bit active. Exhale as you press. We're in these moves for 45 seconds each. We have a cat and cow neck, so we're gonna flip it over. Ready. We're gonna flip it. We're coming onto our quadruped position. Knees are directly underneath your hips, wrists, elbows, and shoulders are all in one line. You're going to push through the hands, pushing through the upper back. And then you're arching through the back, tailbone, eyes towards the ceiling. Go back through, push, push, push. And arch. And push. And relax. We're gonna stay in that position. We're going for alternating glute kickbacks. So in this position again, you're gonna flex both your feet, kick it back with your right, bring that back in. Kick it with your left, bring it back in. As you kick here, you're squeezing through the glutes. Really squeeze and reach that heel towards the opposite side of the room. Reach. And reach. And reach. And relax. All right, set it back a second. Shake out your shoulders, shake out your wrists. We're gonna take it from a plank into a down dog. Ready, onto your toes, wrists, elbows, shoulders in alignment. Your plank, you're pushing that chest forward, slight tuck of your hips, and then you're pushing that tailbone, hips towards the ceiling. Come back into that plank. And down dog, sorry, the table is in my way. And hold each one for just a second. And relax. All right, we're going to go into a kneeling hinge. So you're sitting on your heels. Your knees can be a little bit wide here. We're gonna press those hips up. set it back down, press those hips up, set it back down. Keep going here. We have one more movement after this. If you need a little bit less range of motion here, you can be on your flexed feet. I feel like I may have missed one hip bridge. We may have missed one, guys. I'm not sure. My watch is saying a different movement, but we'll see. We will see. And relax. All right, we're going to come into a kneeling spinal wave. So you're going to kneel, standing up, fingertips brush your ears, chin to chest, roll it down. Once you get about to your belly button or hip height, you're going to arch and come up. So you're rolling it down, arch and come up. I know it feels a little bit funny. For your first part today, you are going to need your band and you're going to need your kettlebell. We've got some weight at work and some band work today. Try to give me one more here. And relax a second. All right, I'm going to show you what's in part A, our booty section. We're first going to stand up. We have two rounds, 45 seconds on, 15 seconds off. We're going to stand up and go for our deadlift. So you're going to need your bell here. Bell starts between your feet. You're going to maintain a neutral bend in your knees. Okay, I don't want them locked out here. Neutral bend. Roll those shoulders back. Hinge at the hips, pushing that butt back towards the opposite wall. Once you feel that stretch in your hamstrings, push through those big toes, stand it up. You're gonna be here for 45 seconds, okay? After that, you're coming down onto the ground. The rest of your movements are on the ground. You're gonna put that band on right above the knees. You're gonna grab that weight. We're going for banded, weighted glute bridges. So it's the same thing we did in our warm-up. The only difference is this time you have a band pushing those hips to the ceiling as your knees are pushing against that band, trying to open it up, okay? After that one, we have a banded abduction. You're leaving the band on, but you're dropping the weight. You're going up into that bridge, holding it here. You're going to pull the knees out, out, and back in. Go ahead and stand up for your deadlifts. We're going in 5 seconds. Grab your weights. Set yourself up, hinge. I'll show you the other two moves once we get there. Inhale on the way down, exhale as you squeeze through to stand. For your bridge, grab your weight, put that on your hips. Big breath in, plant your heels and push up and up. Your hands are just resting on the bell to keep it supported so it doesn't fall. If you need a mat or a pillow or something across your lap so that the bell's not uncomfortably resting on your crotch, feel free to do so. All right, move that weight off to one side. We're gonna go up, staying in that bridge. this time, we're gonna open our knees. Ready? Plant those heels. It's open and close. Open and close. Y'all know my lights blind me. So if I can't see after this, that's why. After this move, you're gonna keep the band on, but you are going to need your weight. We're gonna flip it where we're laying on our left side. So your right leg will be on top. Just press and close and press and close. Slow control, slow control. Keep going here, y'all. And relax, bring that down. Flip it over onto your left. This time your feet are gonna be together. You pull your band up a little bit further, it's gonna make it easier. Your bell goes onto that quad being supported by that hand. You're gonna open and close. Open and close. I will say, it gets a little bit awkward trying to put a kettlebell on your quad. Competition bells are easier, but mine is in my car because they have a wider base. Additionally, if you have a dumbbell, you can do that if it's really uncomfortable for you because of the weight being directly on the muscle in a weird way. You can drop the weight, take it out for this round, and just do regular clams to make it a little bit harder. Take that band just a little bit closer to your knees. Ready? We're gonna flip it over. Finishing up round one of part A. Doing the same thing, opposite side. Big breath in. Ready? Join me here. Keep those feet together. Open through the knees. After this, we have one more round of booty. Really squeeze. Put your hand there, feel that muscle. Now you can keep your band on for your next deadlift. I'll show you that. It's up to you. You can take your band off. Our second final round. Ready? You can keep your band on like me. Pick up your weight, set your feet, hinge it back, squeeze, push through the toes to stand. If you have a mirror or you want to film yourself, I'm a huge fan of that just because it helps you see where your form is lacking. Y'all have your bridge after this, so keep your weight, safely make your way to the floor. Ready, come on down. Get into your position, get that weight on your hips. Ready? Press it up and down and press. Your head, neck, and shoulders can be up or down. It really just depends on what's most comfortable for you. Side, we're going into those abductions. So bridge it up, open and close, open and close. Yeah, it looks like glitter might somehow have made it onto my cat picture. So it keeps like catching the light and I'm like, what is that? Really press those hips up, guys. This is the last time you have to do these abductions today. But they are my favorite move. They really create that nice round shape. Bridges and abductions, because bridges work underneath your glutes. So it gives you that lift. But abductions really help work the sides where the glutes start to wrap around. So that really plumps up the muscle, rounding it out, and relax. All right, we're coming onto our left side this time for those clams. Ready, feet together. Don't wait for me. I'm struggling with my blanket here. Feet together and open up that knee. Open, close, open, and close. We have one more move in our booty and then you get a rest. We're going into our core after this. Body, keeping those feet together, and lift, close, lift. Your hand that's on top, you can bring those fingertips down just for support. I want you to think about pushing out of that elbow that's on the ground, lifting up through those obliques. So I don't want you to be sinking down like this. That's not what we're doing. Try to keep everything engaged. Still gonna need your bell for our core. You will not need your band. And take that off. All right, I'm gonna put this up in my basket. Y'all just take a second. I'm gonna show you what core is gonna look like. Side bends, okay? You're gonna grab your weight in your right hand. You're standing straight up, like a plank position. You're sliding that weight slightly forward, aiming to slide it down to the knee. Then you're lifting back up, squeezing through the obliques. When you come back up, I want you to come in this plank position, okay? We're not overextending here. So that's the first move. Then we're gonna switch it for the second move. Third move, you're coming down into an oblique reach. Left arm is gonna be on the ground. Your knees can be bent or they can be straight. I want you to lift up, reaching for the ankle or toes. It's the same thing if they're bent. We're gonna switch for our fourth move. Do the same thing opposite side. Last movement, you're gonna have weighted sit up. So you have options. You can hold the weight at your chest, or you can squeeze the weight between your feet and reach. And reach. You're probably gonna see me here most of the time, but I'll show you option. If you wanna hold the weight, I'll probably do one and one actually. All right, so that's what we've got. We have two rounds. Go ahead and pick up your weight in that right arm. Stand it up. We're going into our side bends on the right. Ready? Big breath in. Exhale and lift. What I want you to think about is you're not going straight down the side. You are slightly driving that bell slightly forward versus being directly on the side of your body. You're going to get a little bit more out of this move when you do that. Whew. kettlebell down. All right, we're just gonna pick it up in the opposite side. Ready, hair is all knotted. It needs washed. Big breath in, big breath out. Inhale, squeeze. Through this one because it takes a lot of breath out of you because you're literally kind of folding in half. Ready, big inhale. You're gonna exhale, reach. One more. Stand it on up. We're gonna go for our side bends. Ready? Pick it up in your right. Slide that weight down. Exhale, lift. Thank you. know, we love this shit. We love this shit. Okay, we're gonna pick it up in our left hand. This is our last side bend. Ready? Pick it on up, guys. Inhale. And relax. Set that bell down and out of the way for a second. This time I'm going to go with my bended knee, folks. Okay? Because we still have a finisher, guys. We're not done. We're not done. On that left side, ready? We're going to reach for that right exhale. You'll have 15 seconds left. Relax, guys. Take a big breath in. I'm gonna grab some water really quick. Big breath. In through the nose. Breathe out through your mouth. I'll take a second. We're heading into our finisher. We have one move, 45 seconds on, 15 seconds rest for three rounds. Okay? Got this. You can move your mats if you're using a mat. All we have is a kettlebell swing. That's it. Working the booty and core still. Okay. So in your kettlebell swing, your bell's going to start in front of you. You're going to slide about a foot behind it. You're going to hinge, pushing those hips back towards the opposite wall. Now, I can't reach the bell from here, obviously. So in this position, my hinge position, I'm going to push through, bend my knees, grab the weight, tilt that towards me, push those shoulders down. So this should be your starting position. Your weight's in your heels. You're going to hike, thrust that weight up, okay? You have three rounds, 45 seconds. Big breath in. Go ahead, let's set up. Hinge, bend, grab the weight, tilt that towards you, weights in your heels, push down those shoulders. Big breath in. Powerful thrust through your hips.